Okay, so how did you discover the spherical standing wave structure?
I was curious. 1955, I took a course in quantum mechanics, and this was a graduate course, and I had never had a course, any course in quantum mechanics. I assumed I was very stupid. I never understood the origin of de Broglie waves, which says that a particle goes along like this. It has a wave which is inversely proportional to its momentum. Planck's constant divided by the mass times the velocity. That's called the de Broglie wavelength because de Broglie first proposed it. Of course, de Broglie didn't know where it came from either. Nobody ever knew. But I didn't know that they didn't know.
So you thought you were...
Thought I was stupid. I never opened my mouth in a class. 30 years later, I just kept thinking about that thing, and it just bothered me all the time. One day I was reading a book called All About Waves by a professor at Harvard. It suddenly occurred to me that there must be some kind of a complicated Doppler going on. I wrote down a few equations. I discovered that only if you have a combination of an inward wave and an outward wave do you get the de Broglie wavelengths.
You're talking about a combination of an inward wave and an outward wave of two different particles.
Yeah, two different particles.
So you're talking about an interaction of four waves.
Right. There's a particle here, a particle there.
One's moving relative to the other.
So there is relative motion. Therefore, if you write these equations out, you get that the de Broglie wavelength is there. And I was also amazed to discover that Einstein's increase of mass was there. All the things which happened with relative velocity showed up. And I said to myself, this is so simple. I didn't think I discovered anything.
I must admit, when you tell me this, Marlo, it sort of gives a shiver down my spine.
Oh, yeah.
Because what you're telling me is that you've united quantum theory with Einstein's special relativity.
Yeah.
In that one equation.
Yeah, I did.
That's what you're telling me, isn't it?
But this seems so simple to me because these simple bits of algebra weren't all that complicated. So I says, yeah, this is a natural result. I'm sure somebody else has already found this because people investigated quantum theory and waves, and people have been using in and out waves for 30 years. They always thought they were imaginary, though, not real. I went back and I searched for 6 months, and little by little, I realized nobody had ever found this. I must be the only one. But it took several months for me to realize that. When I realized it, I said, gee, I really got something. So I kept on studying and investigating it. And of course, the result is this book. This tells all of that work.